Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial we are going to animate this RoboCat using only the Morph Transition and without using any of the PowerPoint animation effects. So let's get started. And this animation is inspired by one of the animation by Grant Jenkins at codepen.io, and this animation is further inspired by one of the short at dribble.com by Javier Ibanez. So I tried to replicate the same animation in PowerPoint and hopefully you will like it. So before we begin, let me show you the outline view of this presentation. And here you can see all the shape layer that I used to draw this RoboCat. And if I expand this thumbnail view, then you can see that we have total 20 slides, and that is the outline view. And we have the same number of slides in the fill colored view. And from the very first slide, if I open the animation pane from the animations tab, then you can see that I have only added the background music and there is no animation effect, and that applies to all the 20 slides. And if you go to the transitions tab, then you can see that we have applied the morph transition, and that has been applied on all the slides. And you can see the duration of the morph transition, that is very short, that is only 0.01 seconds. However, I would like to apply more shorter duration, but PowerPoint only support up to 0.01 second duration. If you want to apply 0.001, then it is not possible in PowerPoint, and that is because if you want to run more frames within a second, then it could be a little bit difficult and the animation will not very much smooth, as you have seen in the preview that the walk cycle is not very much smooth. And there are a lot of reasons behind that. The first reason could be that I am only using 20 frames. You can call 20 slides or 20 frames. So the concept of this animation is very easy to understand. We are using 20 different poses on 20 different slides. Each slide contains a different pose of this RoboCat. Like that is the first slide, and if I move to the second slide, then you can see the movements in different parts of this RoboCat. So as I move forward, then you can see you can use the down and up arrow keys in the thumbnail view to move between the slides. So if I move between the slides, you can see that how that will behave. So even if you don't have the morph transition, you can still download this presentation, and the link of this presentation is given in the video description, and you can download this presentation for free. And if you don't have the morph transition, then what you can do, you can select all of the slides in the thumbnail view by selecting the first one and then hold down the shift key and then select the last one, and don't apply any of the transition, set it to none, and then adjust the advanced slide timings. Uncheck this option on mouse click and make a check mark on after, and then apply a short duration of 0.01 seconds to each of the slides and press the enter key. Now let's move to the first slide and see the slideshow. And now we are going to see the slideshow without the morph transition. So before that, I would like to mute this background music, and for that I will open the selection pan and will hide these both media files and will close the selection pan. Now let's see the slideshow, and we will notice the difference if we apply the morph transition and create the same animation without any transition. So let's see the slideshow. So it is almost behaving in the same manner. So that is why I told you that you can also create the short animated scenes in PowerPoint without using any animation effect and transition. And that is by applying different poses of a character on each of the slides. But before you jump into this topic, let me show you the outline view. And you must draw the character in a very well manner. You must also note down the position of each of the shape layer, either it is a group shape layer or a single shape layer. You must note down that how these layers has been placed over each other. So if I show you the colored view of the same presentation, and here if I open the selection pan and let me collapse all of these group shape layers. Now if we select this one, then that is the right hand, and you can see the position of this right hand. And if I move it, then you can see that it is behind the gun and on top of the antenna. If I move it here, then it will cover the antenna because it is on top of that. So you must note down the position and place the shape layers properly before you start creating more poses of the same character on different slides. So once you have your character ready and you have positioned all the shape layers, then what you can do, you can duplicate this slide by right clicking in the thumbnail view and then choose duplicate slide. And on the second slide, you just need to change the position of the objects that you want to move. Like I want to move this gun right here and this hand a little bit here, and then rotate it like that. And now you can repeat the same steps to create more poses of the same character. Like I am now duplicating the second slide, and on the third slide I will move this gun a little bit up, the ears a little bit down, and now I want to also move these eyes. But when I select this object, then that is a part of this grouped object. So if you want to select a particular shape layer within from a grouped object, then you just need to click on that shape once more like this, and then you can either resize, you can change the position without grouping or ungrouping that particular shape layer. So let me undo this. So to create these kinds of animations, you might need to move the shape layers which are a part of the grouped object. So my last video on how to work inside grouped shape layers explain this topic in much detail, that how you can group, ungroup and regroup shape layers, and how you can use the selection pan and can take the help of selection pan to easily work inside the grouped shape layers. So if you want to select a particular shape layer within from a group, you just need to click on that particular shape, or you can also use the tab key and shift tab key to move forward and backward between a group shape. So using the same method, I just change the position of different shape layers on different slides. So as I move forward, you can see that I just change the position of the legs and the arm and the gun and the face, the head, the ears. As I move forward, you can see that I have done nothing except for changing the position of the shape layers. So that is what it all takes to create a short animated scene in PowerPoint by creating different poses of a character and then run the slideshow within a very short duration. If we have given the time duration of 0.01 seconds and we have 20 slides, that means all the slides will get played within 0.20 seconds. And so normally when we watch a video, then we usually see 25 frames within a second. So that means when 25 pictures move within 1 second in front of your eyes, then it creates a motion. So that is what we are doing in PowerPoint. We are creating separate poses of the same character on different slides, and then we are applying the advanced slide timings as we need, like 0.01 seconds. So that was just an example and a method of creating short animated scenes in PowerPoint by first drawing your character and then just duplicating the slides and moving the position of the shape layers as you want to move the character. And I hope you will like this method. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye and take care.